This time, I'm going to show you Linear's Pipe Offset command for Revit. With the help of this command, you can resolve collisions of various kinds automatically and comfortably. I have prepared several collisions in this example to illustrate this. So here we have a collision of two pipeline corridors, which we will resolve. The second collision is between one of the corridors and a structural beam within the linked architecture model. Finally, to show you a special feature of the command, let's look at the collision between four pipes in the boiler room. Let's start with the first one. The pipe offset command works discipline independent, which means that you can find this command in any discipline in the edit area of the linear control board and start it from here. Within the command, you have the option to set distances both horizontally and vertically. Likewise, you can specify the desired angle for the offset here. In this case, we choose an automatic angle determination by the program. You can use the checkboxes to make additional settings, such as use existing fittings. We will take a closer look at this feature at the end. Optionally, you can also take insulation into account when determining the offset. We will leave this active here. The command can be used in three modes. The first mode allows you to offset around elements in the actual project. If you want to fix a collision with an object from a linked model, select the second mode, offset around linked element. The last mode is the manual offset, which allows you to manually implement the offset in a floor plan. When you have made your settings, start the command. The program will first ask you to select the elements that you want to offset. After confirming with Enter, select the elements the offset should bypass. The program determines the possible offset variants and offers them for selection. In our case, there are two possibilities. In the second one, we can already see from the selected section box that pipes were protruded into the ceiling. We therefore decide on the first possibility and select Apply. Now, the offset is automatically implemented with all chosen elements and the collision is eliminated. Let's turn our attention to the second collision of the corridor with a structural beam from the linked architecture model. To be able to select this one, I switch to the mode offset around linked element. In this case, I choose a slightly smaller distance and set the angle to 45 degrees. After starting the command, I again select the elements to be offset and in the next step, the beam. Again, two variants are displayed from which I select the appropriate one and have the offset implemented. The required transitions are generated automatically and this also worked perfectly here. Finally, as promised, I would like to demonstrate the use existing fitting setting. To do this, let's look at the collision of the four heating pipes in the boiler room. To show this even better, I switch off the visibility of the pipe insulation. I adjust the settings again and switch back to the mode offset by element. With the deactivated option Use Existing Fittings, we get a convertible offset, but we also need a relatively large number of fittings over this short distance due to the elbow fitting. I therefore cancel the command and show you the result with activated option. By activating this option, we can very easily save material here by using the already existing fitting. One more time, we get two variants and I also choose the offset to be below. It can be that simple to resolve collisions of all kinds. No more tedious breaking up of pipes for manual collision resolution. With the automatic pipe offset command of Linear, you save a lot of time and get a clean project.